What is going on, friends? We are back with more World Cup. We got TDK versus Roses. Roses playing for US West. Bring this hyper offense. So I assume it's going to be Hazard stacking Skarmory. Maybe even the Z move one. TDK bringing more balance-ish looking team playing for US East. TDK is 1-1 at the moment. This is his third game, and Roses is 1-0. This is his second game. Hello, Momola plus Wish Pass into Heracross and Heatran looking kinda cool. He gets up the rocks and Heatran is faster. Wow, I was expecting the Skarmory to be faster because Skarm usually runs max speed on this type of offense. TDK has his fast Heatran and can prevent the spikes from going up. Now he gets up his own rocks, so Taunt rocks. Lava Bloom Toxic maybe? I don't know. So he goes for 1000 arrows, that looks like a Dragon and Zygarde. That's definitely not Choice Bandit damage. Yeah, I'm really interested to see the Azelf set because he was lead Skarm, so he wasn't lead Azelf. So that's gonna be really cool to see if it's like Life Orb or Z-move Azelf. Even though I'm thinking it was usually Z-move Garra on these type of teams, right? But there's so many potential Z-move users, dude. Like this could be Z-move, this could be. So I don't think it's Azelf. Doubles in the Heatran. Did he break the Skarmory? TDK is unstoppable, dude. Did he go for Toxic breaking the Zygarde? He went for Lava Bloom. Did he get the burn? He did get the burn, and he has no way of getting rid of status. No Healing Wish, no Heal Bell, I think. Yeah. Goes in the Garchomp on the predicted. Wow. Double back into Skarmory. He predicted 1000 arrows. Yeah, he gets up the spikes now. As soon as it's gonna have, yeah, some fire move. Did he flinch? Oh, it's red card, okay. That's really nice. So he gets rid of the setup basically. What did he whirlwind? That was weird. He had red card, dude. He could have gone for another hazard. Can't use taunt after the taunt. He's just gonna sack off his Skarmory because it dies to rocks. Struggle. So Stealthrock spikes were one taunt. No Brave Bird, no anything. That's weird. So he's gonna DD up, I assume, with his Gyarados. He sub? Oh my god. He gets all the hits in regular form. Dude, regular Heracross doesn't even have the ability that lets you hit 5 times. Only the Mega has that. That's wild. Who gets 4 hits, dude? Also, the first one crit, otherwise they wouldn't have broken the sub. That's kinda lucky, not gonna lie. Yeah, Gyarados could have put in a good amount of work. I think that was... Oh, Blunder said Zygarde could 6-0. Why would you go into that on the Lava Plume? I mean, I can not see how Roses can bring this back. Like, this game is over. And he also has Moxie, wow. Because usually I see Guts on Heracross before Mega Evolution, but yeah, Moxie is also cool. So he's either gonna go the Mimikyu or a Azelf here. I think Mimikyu. Watch him go Mimikyu, try to SD up, and this Heracross is gonna Mega Evolve and blow it away. Yeah, if he goes Mimikyu, he's kinda forced to attack. So I think TDK can go Celesteela or Heatran, or actually Alamomola is probably fine. Alamomola should be fine on Mimikyu if it's Fist Staff. I assume the Steeler is gonna be... Did the Steeler come out once? I think it did. But we don't know the moveset from the Steeler. I think TDK can stay in no matter what Roses does, because if he goes to Zelf, if that has Nasty Plot, you don't want to let it set up for free. If he goes Mimikyu, you don't want to let that set up, even though Alamola could prevent that potentially and come out on that. Like, he could still EA plus to hit, is what I'm trying to say, and get a potential Sculpt or not Toxic off. And on Magina's like the main thing that you would never switch out on, because you know Magina's busted and can run through your team. Especially with rocks and spikes up. But he goes on Azulf. So like I said, he's either gonna stay in and... CC might kill a plus one. I can't really run the cult because my net is really slow at the moment. But if CC doesn't kill, he's gonna go for like Rock Blast Pin Missile. He goes for U-turn expecting him to switch into Celesteela or Heatran. And yeah, this game is just over. Like, I understand that like Roses had to like try and predict something. Is he Scarf Azelf? Because U-turn Azelf is weird. I think he could be Scarf. Like, this game is just so over. Yeah, see, that's what I was talking about. Like, he never switched this out. He didn't really have to. Okay, we know this is leftover, so he's just gonna go for Heavy Slam to break the Mimikyu's disguise. Yeah, Heavy Slam also hits the other mods decently hard. I don't think there's a reason to go for Flamethrower. I mean, he can, doesn't really matter. Is he Fistav if he goes to this? I think this would be Spadev to help versus Celesteela, to help versus Magearna. Even though it's not the best Magearna answer, because some of them carry Gigavolt Havoc. Yeah, I wouldn't protect here, because this can obviously SD up. So obviously just attack. I think he got up... Did he get up rocks with his Garchomp? No, he got up rocks with his Heatran, right? So Garchomp could be Z move, I don't remember if... Garchomp used so far? Nothing. Did Latios use? Also, but yeah, he has to try an SD up because like he needs that boost. He just Heavy Slams. And another Heavy Slam is gonna kill this. We do see it's not... Was it Life Orb? Oh, no, it's not Life Orb, it's Z-Move Mimikyu. That Shadow Claw did nothing. Was it not Z-Move Mimikyu? If it was Z-Move, he could have gone for it there. But he was Fist of Celesteela. Which answers my question, like, why he went into this over, like, Alamomola. I mean, I think the correct Magearna set could have won versus him. I don't think at this point he can win, but, like, Magearna. But in general, he seems a bit weak to Magearna. Maybe he's Max Spadef Alamomola and he has Mirror Coat or some tech. Not sure about that. But Bolt Beam, Z Focus Blast, Standard Magearna with Shifki seems really threatening to this type of team. If you get it in on the correct Mon, like if you get it in on a Lali locked into Psyshock or something like that. But he is Fizdev Steeler for. Like it helps for. SDZ move Landorus, what else is this good for? I can't really think of anything specific where you would run Fist of Steeler for. Like that you would run Fist of Steel if I was what I'm trying to say. Like katana is not really used much. It would help versus katana. It can take a hit from... It can help versus SDZ Outrage Guard Jump a lot, that's for sure. I don't know if it eats the plus to Z Inferno Overdrive Fire Fang from Guard Jump. He probably has to shift gear up here because otherwise he doesn't outspeed like those three mons. I mean, he doesn't outspeed the Laddie anyway. But he just goes for the T-Bolt, he gets the boost. But now he doesn't outspeed the Garchomp. That's my issue here. He doesn't outspeed Garchomp and Heatran without if he doesn't shift gear. I mean, Earthquake probably doesn't kill from Garchomp from this range. But I think it would bring it in range to die from like Psyshock or something from Laddie. Lava Bloom is gonna do a lot. Yeah, he can taunt. This is the right play from DDK's part, I think. I don't know if he's gonna taunt. So this can't shift gear up. Or if he's just gonna Lava Bloom. He's probably gonna run some Kulks. He's gonna run some Kulks for how much max HP Megina takes if it's Trick Room, and he's gonna run a Kulk for offensive Megina with shift gear. And then he's gonna figure out the play. I think Taunt should be the better play. Like, this itself looks like Scarf to me, so I don't think it can win versus Alamomola. So even if you Taunt this and this goes for Z move, that's fine because the combination of Earthquake into Psyshock should kill this, and Alamomola should be able to beat the Azelf, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe I'm wrong here. It is 1:50 a.m. in the night, by the way. I might sound a bit weird because I'm recording in a different room. My fast internet died earlier, so yeah, I had to move down. This net is pretty ass, which is why I'm not running any Kulks. He goes for Ice Beam, which makes no sense. I guess he's going for the freeze, yeah. Yeah, he's going for the freeze. He's going for his Wincon. Maybe he doesn't have Focus Blast then, or he just had to get the freeze to set up on this, but yeah, he said GG. I don't think he has Focus Blast. Yeah, he turned into it carelessness, and this was heavily in DDK's, this was pretty... I mean, it's only a 3-0 at the end, but like DDK was in control pretty much the entire game. And yet a burn on the Zygarde sucked. Especially if he has like substitute on Zygarde and can potentially set up on Alamomola with like Toxic. That could be helpful for... Could have been helpful for Rose, but... Yeah, I don't think... Like, the game would have been closer without the burn on Zygarde, but I don't know if it was a game changer. Yeah, so TDK is 2-1 now. Roses is 1-1, and I don't think there's gonna be more World Cup games. Kinda sad that I can't upload this right now, probably gonna be up the next day. Unless my net decides to come back this night. But thank you guys for watching. TDK picking up the win for US East, and this was kind of like, at least it was a fast-paced game, no stall. And I'll see you guys next time with more World Cup action. I think I recorded. Yeah, I recorded like 4 games today. I haven't uploaded one yet, which is the Value versus Star Master one. I haven't uploaded that one. That one was also cool. So check that out for sure. I always link some of the old games if you haven't seen them at the end of the video. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time, and have a nice day. Goodbye.